Hello, this is Mocha Product Manager Martin Brennand, and welcome to this tutorial on using Python to capture menu actions in the Mocha interface. So this is going to require a little bit of Python knowledge, but if you're not very familiar with Python, we're going to walk you very slowly through the whole thing. So let's get started. So today we're going to be looking at something called an action trigger handler, and this is used to capture various actions within the Mocha interface. We can use this to capture, say, for example, what we're going to do here, a save project action, and then either augment it or prevent it from happening entirely. So the first thing we need to do when we're doing any code in Mocha is bring up our script editor. So I'm going to come over to my view menu. Let's grab Python script editor right down the bottom here. And there's our Python script interface. Now you can also set up a layout for this. I've already got a Python layout here, but if you need it, you can just grab it from that view menu. So I'm going to be doing like a copy and paste thing here. I'm not going to type out absolutely everything because that'll be a very slow tutorial, but we'll go through everything line by line. So the first thing we need to do is actually import the stuff we need to use these scripts. So I'm going to import from the Mocha UI, which is our UI module inside the Mocha API. We're going to import get menus, which, as it says on the tin, gets the menus inside the interface. And we're also going to import this important class action trigger handler, which will do all the meat of our action capturing today. The next thing we need to do is actually find the menu that we actually want. And in this case, if we're getting the save project, we need to get the file menu. Now, inside Mocha, these object names have special names under the hood. They're not just file and view. They're called specific parameter names. And we can find that out by actually just printing out all the get menus. So if I just say print, and then inside the print statement, I say get menus, that thing that I just imported. So when we run this script, it prints out every menu that's actually in the interface, which is kind of handy. So what we want to look for is under our Qt widgets, anytime there is a Q menu, we can see its name. So down here, we can see we've got menu view, which is our view menu. We've got menu help, which is our help menu, and so on and so forth. So what I want to look for is something called menu file. So we go and clear this, and I'm going to get rid of that get menus. And so we're going to pull that information out of get menus. So what I'm going to do is let's just copy and paste in the next line. So I'm going to set up a new variable called menu file, and it's going to equal that get menus function that we just did. And then we're going to pull out the name menu file out of that. So this is just pulling out the dictionary entry from that get menus instance. So now that we have that, we can go and dive into that menu file and find the action that we want. In this case, the save project action. So I'm going to draw a new line. And here we want to grab the action we're going to capture. So I'm going to copy and paste in a new line here. This is a fairly long one to type out. So what we're doing here is I'm going to set up a new variable called caught action, the action we want to capture. And then I'm building a little list comprehension here. What we're doing here is I'm saying for A, anytime A in the menu file action list, so actions is the thing that pulls out all the actions from that menu file that we set up first. If the object name equals file save, we are going to assign that to A. And because that generates a list, we just want the first item that says file save, which is why I've just pulled out a little zero there. If you're not too familiar with Python, don't get too bogged down in the details here. Just know that what we're doing here is we're filtering through all the actions in that file menu, and we're looking for the file save variable. Now, in the same way that we do get menus, if you're not sure of what your action name is called, you can also do a print action. So I'll show you how to do that. What I'm going to do is say here, we're going to say for any action inside menu file actions, we're going to print the action object name. So this sounds a little bit different to what we just did, but it's essentially doing a print version of what we're doing in this line. It's just going to list out every single action inside that file menu. So let's go ahead and play that. And we can see here it's listing out all our object names. And the one we want here is file save. So let's clear that out and delete this line. So the next thing we want to do is we want to take that call to action and we want to actually define it as the thing that we want to trigger. So I'm going to now use that thing that we said at the start. We want to set up an action trigger handler. So let's go and paste that in. So I'm going to say action handler, that's our variable. And then we're going to define the action trigger handler class. And inside it, we're going to put our call to action, which is the file save variable up here. So call to action goes inside the action trigger handler. So now we've said this is what we want to trigger. Whenever you see that triggered, let's do something else. And the thing that we're going to do is define a function to take over. So we're going to define a new function. Define my handler, the classic my handler. And we're going to set up a new variable called the caught function. And the caught function is that save project function. So the idea behind this is that this is being fed in, and then we can play that back if we actually want the save project action to trigger. So the next thing we want to do is I'm going to just say in here, print caught action. Then we can actually call that caught function. So I'm going to say caught function, and make sure we're calling the function by putting our little curly brackets at the end, not curly brackets, brackets. And then after that, I'm going to say print completed original action. So here, this function is saying, I've caught the action. I'm now inside the handler that actually is replacing this function. I'm going to play my original caught function, in this case, which is save file. And then I'm going to complete the original action, just telling him that's what's happened. So this little function now is just a little print statement. We'll talk a little bit about what we can do inside that function later, but this is defining what will happen when we've caught the action. Finally, we need to register the action so that it actually happens within the interface. Because at the moment, all we've done is set up all the triggers and the functions, but we haven't actually assigned it to Mocha to say when this happens, actually do it. So that's the final thing we need to set up. So I'm going to pull this in. So what we're doing here is we're saying get this action handler, our little action trigger handler, and set up the dot handler for that. That's the main thing. The dot handler in action trigger handler is the thing that registers the handler to the interface. And then we're going to feed it in the function that we just wrote, my handler. So what we're doing here, let's go from the top. We've imported the things that we need to use for the Python script. We've said, this is the file menu. We need to use that so we can find the right menu. Next, we've said, let's define the caught action. So the action that I actually want to get out of this file menu. And I've gone through a list using the list comprehension here. And then pulled out file save from that list and set it as my variable. Next, I've defined the action handler using action trigger handler and the caught action, which in this case is save file. And then finally, I've set up a function to actually replace the save project function. But we're actually reproducing save project inside it by feeding that caught function back into the handler itself. Then we have to just register the handler and it's ready to go. So at the moment, if I press play, nothing's going to happen because all we've done now is register the handler to the Mocha interface. So if I go ahead now though and save the project, down here we can see we've caught the action and then it's completed the original action, which means that this save function has happened and we can test this out. So I can go and draw another shape here. And if I go and say save project, it's now going to, if I reopen this, it has actually saved the project. So you want to make sure that it's actually doing what it says on the tin. So that's really the nuts and bolts of it. What we've done here is captured the action that we wanted to find, replaced it with a handler, and then just replayed the action after we're done. So now we have this action trigger handler. What's the practical use for it? Well, the best thing to use an action trigger handler for is to augment existing actions within the software. In the case of, say, save project, you might want to back up the project to another location. So I could go over to save project and then write a function after my core function to just copy that project to a network drive or a backup location. Another reason is to maybe export every time you save the project, so that if you are regularly bringing out a file out of your Mocha project, which is, let's face it, what we're mainly doing inside Mocha, you could automatically export your most common format to a watched location. So I'm going to show you an example of that. Let's go and open up this auto export on save. So this is kind of an expanded version of how you would use the action trigger handler. What I've got here is I'm creating a little function called export all layers. So that's going to go through every layer in my file and export out a specific export. And then in the action trigger handler, I've set up a project and I've set up something called an abstract tracking data exporter. And this is a registered exporter that's listed in the Nuke tracker format. We can then use that Nuke tracker format and set it up to a path. And then every time we click save, it'll cycle through all of my layers and export each one as a new tracker file. So there's various ways we can use this captured function to help out. The other kind of more nefarious thing you could do is actually just get rid of this save function entirely and never let the person save at all. So there's different ways you can use it to capture. So that's how you write an action trigger handler inside Mocha Python. If you've got any questions, please do ask them in the comments, or pop over to the forums at borisfx.com, where you can also check out the other BorisFX products and check out all the other tutorials available for Mocha. I've been Product Manager Martin Brennand. Thanks very much for your time, and we'll see you soon.